Hello friends, welcome to the next session on knowledge representation, and we are talking about resolution. You already talked about resolution in the inference rules. If you have not gone through, please go through the previous video to know the inference rules, what we have discussed. So let us look at what is resolution. Okay, it's an inference rule used in both propositional as well as first order predicate logic in different ways. We also call it as proof by repetition. It is basically used for proving the satisfiability of a sentence. Proof by refutation technique is used to prove the given statement. It is an iterative process. Like given a statement, you are supposed to prove whether it is right or wrong. Now, how does it work? It's an iterative process. So what you do, select two clauses that contain conflicting terms, combine those two clauses and cancel out the conflicting terms, yielding a new clause that has been inferred from them, right? So you're taking two clauses, canceling out wherever there's a contradiction, and you're coming up with a new clause. The key idea is to use the knowledge base and negated goal to obtain null clause, which indicates contradiction. Since the knowledge base itself is consistent, the contradiction must be introduced by negated goal. As a result, we have to conclude that the original goal is fine. The concept will be more clear as we go ahead and look at the example. So let us see what are the steps we need to follow in resolution. The very first step is, given the statement, you need to convert them into first order logic, like predicate form. Now, after you convert it into predicate form, you need to convert it into conjunctive normal form. We have already seen how to convert a statement into conjunctive normal form. If you are not gone, please go through the video which is already uploaded. Negate the statement to be proved and add the result to the knowledge base. And the fourth one is, once you negate the result, what you need to do, you need to draw the resolution graph. If empty clause is produced at the end of the resolution graph, then stop and report that original theorem is true. Fine. Now looking at the example, we'll be using all these steps so the concept will be more clear. Let us look at a very simple example. You have the set of statements given. There are five statements given. If it is sunny and warm day, you will enjoy. The second statement, if it is raining, you will get wet. Third, it is warm day. Fourth, it is raining. Fifth, it is sunny. You have five statements given, and what is your goal? Goal is to prove that you will enjoy. Is it fine? Goal is to prove you will enjoy. Fine. Now let us start. What was the very first step? First step is to convert it into predicate, right? Conversion to the first order logic. So if it is sunny and warm day, you will enjoy. So if it is sunny and warm, then you will enjoy, right? If it is sunny and warm, then you will enjoy, right? So we could convert this into predicate form. Similarly, the second statement, if it is raining, you will get wet. If it is raining, then you will get wet. So you have an implication here. It's a warm day, so it is just a simple warm single clause. Similarly here, it is raining, so there is no other thing to associate. So it's simple raining, it is sunny. Is it fine? So we could convert the simple statements into first order logic form. Now the next statement is convert them into conjunctive normal form. Now we already know whenever you want to convert a statement into conjunctive normal form, what we need to eliminate this implication. How do you eliminate the implication? By adding a negation and or connective, right? So we rewrite again by eliminating the implication. We say negation of sunny and warm, or is replaced by or enjoy. Now the next statement, you need to move this negation inside. Right? Whenever you move the negation inside, this end becomes or. End becomes or. So negation of sunny or negation of warm or enjoy. Is it fine? So this statement we could convert into CNF. Now, the second statement we had, raining implies wet. So again, elimination of implication, what will happen? You will have a negation and you will have a or. So negation of raining or wet. Is it fine? You could eliminate the implication here. So now this is also again in CNF form. Now, these warm, raining, sunny are already in CNF form because there are no connectives associated with it. These are single literals. Fine. So they remain same. Now, what we'll do using these CNFs, we'll be drawing a resolution graph. So what is the step three? Step three is negate the statement to be proved. What was the statement to be proved is enjoy. Now we are saying negation of enjoy. Right? This is my statement. Step three. Step four is what? Resolution graph. Now take the statements one by one and create the resolution. So let us start with our goal, negation of goal, that is negation of enjoy. And we take the statements from here, right? Negation of sunny or negation of warm and enjoy. You say negation of sunny or negation of warm or enjoy. Now, whenever you're selecting the statement on this side, see to it that you have a contradiction related to this. Now, this is negation of enjoy. Here it is simple enjoy. So there is a contradiction, right? These are two conflicting terms which can be canceled. So what we do, we cancel this negation of enjoy and enjoy. What remains? Negation of sunny or negation of warm, right? So you can simply say not sunny or not warm. Now from this, when you have this, now you go back and select again from this, what we select? Warm, right? Because here you have negation of warm and here it is warm. So these two conflicting terms gets cancelled. What remains is negation of sunny or not sunny. Again, you take sunny from here, which is not negated. So again, these are two conflicting terms. They get cancelled and what you get is an empty clause, which is nothing but a contradiction. So after applying proof by refutation or contradiction on the goal, the problem is solved and it has terminated with a null clause. Hence, the goal is achieved. This is a very simple process of resolution. We'll look at some little bit bigger example. Okay, now look at this. Consider the following knowledge base. You have four statements and a goal. The humidity is high or the sky is cloudy. If the sky is cloudy, then it will rain. If the humidity is high, then it is hot. It is not hot. These are the four statements you have. You need to infer these four statements and come up with the conclusion, it will rain. You need to prove this goal, right? Let us look at them one by one. Okay, now steps to convert it to first order logic. The very first statement we take, the humidity is high or the sky is cloudy. So what we do is we take a predicate P. We say, okay, P will represent the humidity is high. Q will represent sky is cloudy, right? This statement is represented by this and this by Q. So how do we rewrite this statement again in the first order logic form? We'll simply say P or Q. Is it clear? We converted this English statement into predicate form P or Q. The humidity is high or sky is cloudy. Fine. Let us look at the second statement. If the sky is cloudy, then it will rain. If the sky is cloudy, then it will rain. So we say sky is cloudy is Q by, because in the previous statement, we already have sky is cloudy. Now, sky is cloudy is already represented using Q. The same thing we'll be using here. Sky is cloudy is represented using Q. Now, it will rain will be representing using R. Right? It will rain will be represented using R. Now, so if the sky is cloudy, then it will rain. If then, what will come? Implication. Q implies R. If the sky is cloudy, then it will rain. Is it fine? So this statement also we could convert it into predicate logic form, that is first order logic. Next. The third statement we have, if the humidity is high, then it is hot. Right? If the humidity is high, if you look at this, the same statement we had in the first also, the humidity is high, the humidity is high. So again, the same P will be here, what we had in the first statement. So again, we say let P represent the humidity is high, and then we have it is hot. So S will represent it is hot. Thus the whole statement will be represented using FOL will be P implies S. Is it fine? P implies S. Let us look at the next statement now. The last one, it is not hot. right? We already have it is hot in the previous slide, which was represented using S. So here you will have just it is not hot, that is negation of S. Fine. So all the four statements are in now in FOL form, that is first order logic form. What was our goal? Goal was it will rain, so it is again represented using R. Now the next step, convert them into conjunctive normal form, right? This we there is no need to do any conversion because it is already P or Q, so it remains same. But here what you have implication. So you already know to convert it into normal form, you need to eliminate this implication. How do you eliminate the implication? By adding a negation and or connective, right? So negation of Q or R. Now similar here, again, you need to remove the eliminate the implication. So again, it will be negation of P or S. Negation of S remains negation of S, right? So now these are already in the CNF form, right? This is our second step. Now the third step is what? Negation of goal. Goal was R, it will rain. Now we'll say it will not rain. So negation of R, right? Now what we need to do is we need to draw the graph, the resolution graph using these statements. So what we take P or Q, negation of Q or R. Again, I say when you are selecting it, see to it that there is a conflicting term Q and negation of Q. These are two conflicting terms so that you can cancel them out. So P or Q, negation of Q or R. Now negation of Q and Q gets cancelled. What remains is P or R. P or R. Now again select negation of P or S with this. P and P gets cancelled. These are P and these are two conflicting terms. They get cancelled. What remains? R or S. R or S. Now select the next statement, that is negation of S. So again you have conflicting terms S and negation of S. These two gets cancelled. What remains is R. You already have negation of goal, that is negation of R. So what you get is a empty clause or a null clause. Hence, the goal is proved. Is it fine? Let us look at the last example, which is a little bit bigger and it will make the concept still more clear. Okay, here Sunil likes all kinds of food. Apple and vegetables are food. Anything anyone eats and not killed is food. Anil eats peanuts and still alive. Sohan eats everything that Anil eats. So what you need to prove by resolution? Sunil likes peanuts. Is it fine? So this is your the knowledge base and you need to infer this. Fine. So what is the first step? Convert them into first order logic. Okay. The statement Sunil likes all kind of food. Remember all kinds. So you'll have universal quantifier. For all X, X is food, right? Implies Sunil likes X. Is it okay? Sunil likes all kinds of food. He's converted into FOL. For all X, food X implies likes Sunil comma X. Nothing but Sunil likes X and X is food. The second statement, apple and vegetables are food. Apple is food and vegetable is also food. Is it clear? You just have a and connective here. Now it is in FOL form. The third statement, anything anyone eats and not killed is food. Anything, anyone, so you'll have two universal quantifiers, right? For all X, for all Y. Eats X comma Y and not killed. Remember, not killed X implies Y is food, right? Anyone eats anything and anyone is not killed, then anything is food. Is it fine? For all X, for all Y, eats X comma Y and not killed X implies food Y. Is it fine? Now, Anil eats peanuts and still alive. So what we say, Anil eats peanuts and Anil is alive. Okay. Anil eats peanuts and Anil is alive. The next statement what you have is Sohan eats everything that Anil eats. So how do we make this? Everything, that means universal quantifier will come. For all x, Anil eats x implies Sohan also eats x. If Anil eats x, then Sohan also eats x. Is it fine? And x is nothing but the whatever Sohan eats. It's an eating item. Fine. Next, the last statement, Sunil likes peanuts. Sunil likes peanuts. This was our goal statement also, remember. Sunil likes peanuts. Now here we added two more predicates, right? We have written, for all x, x not killed implies x is alive. If x is not killed, then x is alive. Similarly, the same thing other way around, if you write, for all x, x is alive, therefore x is not killed, right? You have just added two extra predicates here. Fine. Now, after this FOL, now we are going to convert it into CNF, that is conjunctive normal form. What we do for this? The very first thing is eliminate the implications, right? Wherever there are implies sign, connective, just eliminate these implies. So, for all x, x is food implies Sunil likes x. So, how do you remove this? We'll be adding a negation and or, right? Negation and or. Now there is no change required here. There is no implication here. So this statement, second statement remains as it is. Again, here you have an implication, right? So for all x, for all y, eats x comma y and not killed x. So now to eliminate this implication, what we need to put them into the square bracket and add a negation, right? And implication symbol is replaced with or food by. To look at them carefully. Fine. Now, this does not have any implication, so it remains same. We are not making any change here. Now, here again, you have an implication for all x, eats Anil comma x implies eats Sohan comma x. So again, elimination of what we'll have, we'll add a negation and or symbol or connective. So negation and or connective. Is it fine? Similarly here, we'll have negation of negation killed. So again, we'll put a square bracket, negation of negation killed x, square bracket complete or alive. So this implication is replaced by negation and or. Similarly, in the last statement, alive x, same thing here. Again, you put negation of alive. This is replaced by or negation of killed. Now, Sunil likes peanuts remains same. There is no change in this. Is it fine? So, from these statements which are green in color, we could eliminate the implication connected. But the next thing is what? Now, you need to move the negation inward and rewrite. Now, there is no negation outside the bracket here. So, there is no change in this statement. There is no change in this statement. These two statements remain same. But if you look at here, there is a negation outside the bracket here. Right, this bracket from here till here, that is negation. So whenever you move the negation inside, what will happen? And becomes or. Fine. So now for all x, for all y, negation of eats x comma y or. It was and here, now it is become or. Now again, if you look at here, it is already having a negation of killed. So negation and negation gets cancelled and it only remains killed x and or food one. Is it fine? The negation of kill gets cancelled here. Now, the fourth statement remains same. There is no change here. In the fifth statement also, there is no negation outside the bracket. Now, if you look at the sixth statement, there is a negation outside the bracket. So you need to move this negation inside. Now, when you move the negation inside, negation gets cancelled and it is only for all x, killed x or alive x. Is it fine? Rest of the statements remains same. There is no change. So we could eliminate the implication. We could move the negation inward and we could rewrite the FOLs. Okay. Now we need to standardize the variables by renaming them. Now why do we need to rename them? Because if you look at the universal quantifier, all the universal quantifiers should have unique variables associated with it. Now, this universal quantifier has x, this also has x, this also has s. So what we need to rename these variables so that each universal quantifier has a unique variable associated with it. So if you look at this side, we are not changed for this. X remains as it is for all x. But in the third statement, which has x, now we are replacing this with y and y with z. So now for all y, for all z, accordingly, the changes are made in the arguments also. Fine. Now, again here for all x, we already used y and z. So we are using w here, right? So this is for all w, it's anil, comma w. The same thing we have written. Fine. So make the changes inside the arguments also. Now for this universal quantifier, instead of x, now we are writing g here. So everywhere g will be replaced. And for the last universal quantifier, we are just making it as a k. Instead of x, we are writing here k. So it is negation of alive k or negation of killed k. Is it fine? What we did, we standardized the variables by renaming them. So each, now if you look this side, all the universal quantifiers have unique variables associated with them. Is it clear? Fine. Now, the next thing is you need to drop the universal quantifier. The best thing is you can directly drop the universal quantifier. There's no change in the statement. Now here, for all x is directly dropped and you already have the remaining statement. Fine. You look not food x or like Sunil comma x. There's no change here because there's no universal. But what we have done here is this single statement, we have written it into two separate statements. Like apple is food and vegetables are food. What we have done, we have broken it into two. This thing, why? Because they're two independent ones. They're not dependent on each other. So we just write apple is a food and vegetables are food. So instead of single statement, we have made two statements here. Is it clear? Now, we just drop the quantifiers here. So only the remaining statement we have written as it is after dropping the quantifiers. Again, this statement, which is again a single statement, Anil eats peanuts and Anil is alive. So I've broken it into two statements because these are two independent statements. So here we write Anil eats peanuts is one statement and the second statement is Anil is alive. Is it fine? So this single statement, we have written it into two statements. Now the fifth one, again, we have dropped the universal quantifier, right? And this remaining statement as it is, similarly here as well as here, we just drop the universal quantifiers. The goal remains as it is, Sunil likes peanuts. The same thing I have written here, statements. These two statements are written into two separate statements, which I put it in a blue color. Is it okay? Okay. Now what is the next statement step is? Next step is to negate the statement to be proved. What was the statement we needed? Sunil likes peanuts. Sunil likes peanuts. So what we are doing now, we are going to negate it. Sunil, negation of likes peanut. Right? After negating the goal, we will be drawing the resolution graph. Now look at the resolution graph clear. Little bit closely. Right? This was the negation of the goal. This is the negation of the goal. Sunil, negation of likes peanut. Right? And then from these, we take the statement one by one. Negation of food X or Sunil likes X. Now what we are doing is we are replacing X with peanuts. Why? Because we need a conflicting term. So both the terms are conflicting, then we can cancel them out. So we are replacing X with peanuts. So what it will become now? Negation of food peanuts or like Sunil comma peanuts. Now X is replaced with peanuts. If you look at it carefully, these are two conflicting terms, not like and like, right? These are two conflicting terms which gets cancelled. And what remains is not food peanuts, right? Not food peanuts. Again, select the next statement, which are already in CNF form. Not eats Y comma Z or killed Y or food z. we need something to match with this. We have food here, we have food here. So what we'll do, we'll replace this variable z with peanuts, right? Replace z with peanuts. So what it will become now? Negation of eats, right? Y comma peanuts, because z we are replacing with peanuts, or killed y, or food peanuts, right? Z is replaced by peanuts. Now food peanuts and negation of food peanuts are the two conflicting terms. They get cancelled. What remains? Negation of eats y comma peanuts or killed y, right? Negation of eats y comma peanuts or killed y. Now take the next statement from the list. Now what it is? Eats Anil comma peanuts. Eats Anil comma peanuts. So now what we need? We need to make them similar. So what we'll do? This y will replace it by Anil. So y is replaced by Anil. So again, it will be negation of eats Anil comma peanuts or killed Anil. Y is replaced by Anil. So now this eats and this negation of eats are two conflicting terms. They get cancelled. What remains is killed Anil. Killed Anil. Right? Now take again the statements from the list. Negation of alive K or negation of killed K. What we need? Killed Anil. So now what we'll do? We'll replace this variable K with Anil. Right? So now it will be negation of alive Anil or negation of killed Anil. So killed and killed gets cancelled. This is negation, right? Contradictory statements or conflicting statements, they get cancelled. What remains is negation of alive Anil. K is replaced by Anil. Fine. Now take the last statement from in there. It is alive Anil. Both the conflicting terms gets cancelled and you get a null clause. It's an empty thing. So it is a contradiction, right? That means hence the goal is achieved. I hope resolution is clear. Try to see the previous video so that the concept will be still more clear. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.